Welcome back to the video series on Advanced Database Management System. This is Kiran Shinde, Assistant Professor, IICMR MC Department. In this video session, we are going to talk on the concept of normalization. Before jumping into the concept, first of all, in this short video, we will understand the concept of functional dependency. And in the next video, we are going to discuss on the normalization. So let's start. So first of all, well, let us try to understand what is the concept of functional dependency. Functional dependency is a very important concept in any relational design. It is nothing but a constraint between two set of attributes from the database. Suppose our relational database schema has n attributes, A1 to AN, then the functional dependency is denoted as X arrow Y between two sets of attributes, X and Y. So here, the X and Y are representing the two sets of attributes. Given these two sets of attributes, then in a relation R, this constraint actually depicts, or this constraint actually denotes the relationship between the two tuples. Now, how is this particular relationship? The constraint is that for any two tuples, now tuple is nothing but a row in a table or record in a table. So this particular functional dependency constraint says that for any two tuples t1 and t2 in a relation R that have t1 of x is equal to t2 of x, if the x value is same for two tuples in that particular relation, then we must also have t1 of y is equal to t2 of y, means we should also have the y value same for the two tuples. Now, this is just the way this particular constraint is put forth, but we will try to understand it easily with the help of examples. This means that the values of y component of a tuple in relation R depend on or are determined by the values of the x component in that particular relation. Or alternatively, we also can say that values of the x component of a tuple uniquely determines the value of the y component of that particular tuple. In other words, x arrow y means given any two tuples in a relation R or in any table, if the x values are the same, then the y and values must also be the same. So this is the basic constraint of functional dependency. We also say that there is a functional dependency from x to y, or that y is functionally dependent on x. The abbreviation for functional dependency is FD. Okay, so let's try to understand with some example. Consider a relation schema employee project. The name of the schema is EMP_PRJ. And there are some attributes which are mentioned in this particular bracket here. The SSN, P number, hours, E name, P name, and P location. Now, there are three examples which are written here in order to understand what is functional dependency. So there are three functional dependencies which are mentioned here with respect to the relation schema EMP-PRJ. That is nothing but the functional dependency is first A, SSN. SSN stands for social security number of the employee. SSN uniquely determines the name of the employee. Second functional dependency can be read like this. The project number can be uniquely determined, or rather, the project number uniquely determines the project name and the project location. And the third functional dependency says the social security number and the project number combinedly together determines the number of hours allocated to that particular project. So here if you see the left-hand side of this functional dependency, which is nothing but the set of X attributes, and the right-hand side is nothing but set of Y attributes. So in my left-hand side, every X attribute is uniquely determining the value of the Y attribute, and that is why they have put in this particular fashion saying it's a functional dependency with respect to relation schema EMP-PRJ. So the explanation is here again. A, the value of an employee social security number uniquely determines the employee name. Value of project number uniquely determines the project name and the location of the project. A combination of SSN and project number uniquely determine the number of hours the employee works on that particular project per week. Alternatively, we also say that the employee name, that is E name, is functionally determined by SSN. Or given a value of SSN, we know the value of E name for sure. okay, and that is why this is an example of a functional dependency x determines y, where the x attribute uniquely determines the value of the y attributes. Let's proceed further. Now this is again with the help of table. Here we have taken into consideration a table having three attributes: loan number, branch name, and amount. The two functional dependencies you can see here: a loan number, since you can see every value in the loan number attribute is unique, so loan number is here a primary key attribute, right? We know what is the primary key attribute, so loan number can uniquely determine the amount which is representing that particular loan. So here, as an example, if I say loan number 11, then the amount will be 900. If I say loan number 16, then the amount will be 1300 only. So from these loan numbers, we can uniquely determine the value of the amount, because amount can be repeated. Like you can see, loan number 14 and loan number 15, they have borrowed the same amount, right? But with the help of number, we will be able to understand exactly what is the amount which is borrowed against this particular loan number. Similarly, the loan number can uniquely identify the branch name. As we understand, if one bank has got different branches, so every branch will have its own way to decide the nomenclature for that particular loan number representing that branch loan, right? So loan number is here uniquely determining the value of the branch name. So these are some more examples. Again, here one more table we have taken into consideration, where you can see the branch name is kept as unique. So branch name is playing the role of a primary key here. So branch name can uniquely define the branch city, or uniquely determine the value of the branch city. And the branch name also can uniquely understand or make us understand the assets with respect to that specific branch of the bank. Okay, so these are some more examples with respect to functional dependency. So the motive of this short video was to only make you understand what is the concept of functional dependency, because this concept will be very, very useful for you to understand the next video session or the video lecture, which is we are going to talk on what is normalization. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned for my next video.